Know what collinear means. Raise your hand if you know what collinear means. And before we get started, if your name is up here, I need an email from your parent or I will be making phone calls. There's only a few, so it's not a big deal, but I'd rather get an email and take care of it that way. Does anybody know what collinear means? Nobody in here can tell me what collinear means? Okay, let's do it in a straight line. In a straight line, like this. Remember Mama Duck and Baby Duck? Okay, in a straight line. Skew is two lines that are not parallel, but they do not intersect because they're on different planes. So different planes do not intersect. Not parallel, and no intersection. I think I had you take your pencils one day and twist them. Okay? They're not parallel, and they do not intersect. They are called skew. Okay? Coplanar. Does anybody know what that one is? Coplanar. Your feet, all your shoes are on the floor. That is coplanar. Coplanar is all points on a flat surface. All the points on a flat surface are coplanar. Your feet are all on the floor. They are coplanar. Your hands are non-coplanar with your feet because they're not on the floor. Two planes intersect. I folded a paper one day. Does anybody know where two planes intersect? Yeah. At a line. Okay, so it would look something like this if I had to try to draw it. And there it is right there. So two planes intersect at a line. Try to draw that, please. Like if you fold a piece of paper or the wall meeting the ceiling. Two planes intersect at a line. It is a test question. It is on the EOC. All of this is on the EOC. What does collinear mean again? Anybody know? In a straight line. Very good. Okay, don't worry about it if you can't draw it, but try. Okay, that's all I'm asking you to do. All right, next. Graph. If you haven't graphed this already, I want you to do so right now. So draw your X and your Y and graph those two points. And then we're going to translate it. Okay? All of this stuff we talked about. Monday, we're going into Chapter 2. And I think you guys already tore out Chapter 2. So that won't be a problem. All right, let's see how it looks. So I go negative 2 and then down 4. So 1, right about here is A. And then I'm going to go over 3 and then up 2. And that's B. All right, connect this. All right, now we're going to translate it. We're going to take this point and the other point, and we're going to use this rule. So where the X is, you're going to put a negative 3. So we're going to push it to the left 3 spaces is what we're doing. And then we're going to go up 3 spaces. So put a plus. This is on your test. It's on today's worksheet as well. Any questions about what I'm saying or what I'm doing so far? All right, let's write the new points. So put A prime and B prime. So if I do a minus 2 and a minus 3, I get a minus 5. This one is going to give me a minus 1. It's really not hard, so don't make it hard. It's not. I want you to graph these new points. Graph the new point. One of them is called the preeminent, and one of them is called the image. Label which one is the preimage, and label which one is the image. Anyway, this one right here is going to be a negative 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then down 1. So put A prime. And then the other one is over 0. Again, this is not really hard. You can do it. And if you look at it, it looks like we did slide it over this way, 3 spaces, and then we did go up 3 spaces. And that's all we did. We just took it and slid it. Does anybody know what that's called when you slide an image? Yes? Translation. So you might want to write that down. Translation. And translation is a form of transformation. Transformation is like the big name, and everything is under that. Like if you rotate something, if you slide something, if you flip something. Flipping is called reflection. Bless you. All right, put away your bellwork. Here's how we're going to handle it today. Now I need you to listen, because all it takes is one person to mess it all up. Okay, and it'll be that one person that doesn't pay attention. All right, so let me video this first for the parents at home. All right, when I call you up, the answers are right here so you can check it. You're going to take 2 pages. If you don't take 2, that's where it's going to mess up, because it's collated. So you have to take 2 or it's going to mess up. I'm not going to pass these things out, too many of them. So the first row is going to come up this way, like a snake, okay? Grab 2, go have a seat. All right, come on up. Reach down there and grab 2. So you already have one? Very good. Next row. All right, start on your practice test. Yep, these are yours. Your parents actually have a link to it as well. All right, you're welcome. Did I miss anybody? All right, good luck. Work on it for about 30 minutes, and then I'll answer your questions, and I'll have it on video tonight. The answers are on the back. Put a mark by the ones you know you need to study. Do not just copy it down. Make sure you understand why. Because when I click a button, it's going to change the numbers and letters and stuff. So make sure you understand why. And again, I'm going to give you probably about 15 minutes, maybe 20 minutes, and then I'll work some. Thank you.
that is.